Everybody can have a seat. Good evening, everyone. Good evening, graduates, faculty, family, friends, and our distinguished guests. I'd like to welcome everyone and thank you for being here to help us celebrate our 19th graduating class of technical at Beaver Community and Technical College. This is always such a special time for us as faculty and students. It's such hard work, nursing school is hard. And it's not supposed to be easy. So we know how hard these students have worked and how hard you have worked, the family, to get your student across the finish line. But it is such a special time for everyone here. It's a time to recognize and celebrate our students' achievements and hard work. Nursing school, like I said, is not easy. Students sacrifice time with family, holidays, they sacrifice special occasions on their journey to become a nurse. However, no matter how hard it was, these students were resilient and they made it. They achieved their goal, and we are also very, very proud of our students this evening. I hope that you guys always remember this moment. You never will remember anything that any of us said, but you will always remember the pride that you have. And I hope you let this pride inspire you to always practice nursing with integrity and excellence. Remember that nursing is so much more than a career. It is truly a call. Be in service of those in need every day. You will have the ability to make a difference in someone's life every time you step foot inside your patient. It's a great honor to be a nurse, and with this honor also comes great responsibility and accountability. So always, always, always do your best and never shall fail. With that being said, I'd like to introduce some of our faculty and our guests. John Goldison, he is the instructor on our Beaver campus. Cassie Sturgill is the lead instructor on our Raleigh County campus. Karen Officer is the lead instructor on the Beaver County campus. And we also have Dean Patterson, who is the dean for transfer and pre-professional programs. The faculty would like to come up and say a few words to the students before we start our panning. So I would like for Karen Officer to come up. Karen will be leading us after this year. Her dedication to the program and the students has not gone unnoticed, and we will greatly miss her comments and presence in the program. It has been such a blessing to work with Karen. And we wish her much success in her new position as the clinical coordinator at Summersville Regional Medical Center. And I do want to give you something from all of us faculty and students. Candidacy status this year. There's only one other practical nursing program in the state that has achieved that. So I'm really proud of that, and without him, we wouldn't have been able to have done it. He volunteered countless hours to help us get that achievement. So thank you for everything you've done for us.
Good evening. Dean Patrick Quinn, directors and instructors, graduating students, friends, family. Over the past few weeks, I've thought about what I wanted to say tonight, and there's been multiple occurrences, but also this has been a year that has opened doors to unlimited avenues for you in the future. Learned knowledge and skills and applying them in the workplace, community, and at home will be just the beginning of life of a lifetime of giving and of healing. I remember as if it were yesterday how my career began. You see, I was going to be a music teacher. But things changed when a friend of mine said to me when I was in my first year of college that, come take this nurse's aid course with me. So I decided I would go. She was saying that the hospital needed orderlies, and that, yes, orderlies, I'm that old, but back in that time, orderlies and nursing assistants, okay? So I told her, yes, I'd do that. So I took this evening course, and as I was taking the evening course, I got a certification for that, and I thought, this will get me off the farm. So I was raised on the farm, of course, if you didn't know that. But my dad thought of, he had some different plans for me on that. He said that, yeah, you can get a job, but you're gonna get up early and you're gonna mow that field of hay every day ahead of me, and then you can go to work. So what did I do? I would get up early, mow that field. Of course, it had to be work 3 to 11. That's what I worked, 3 to 11. And I would rush home, take a shower, and I would be going up the road and I would be drying my hair while my head was out the door, you know, trying to get there in time, but I did. But I want to tell you that I enjoyed every moment of that as I was doing that. And it just was something that inspired me that this is really what I want to do. This is the passion that I have. There was lots of friends, lots of laughter, lots of caring that happened during that time. But then my friend also told me, says, go with me to take this LPN entrance exam. So I did, and of course the rest was kind of history on that. Before I knew it, I was enrolled and I was beginning classes. So music took a back burner at that time, okay? And I really knew down deep, even though I loved music and had always, that my path for the future was going to be probably somewhere in the medical field. So, as you can imagine, what everyone thought back in the 70s, a male going into nursing, predominantly is for women, right? So, of course, I was harassed a lot about that, but that didn't stop me from going forward with it. And I went on forward with that, and I have to say, I know that you won't agree with me, but my LPN years were the best I had. They were a blast. I loved every minute of it. We had fun, I had great friends, we enjoyed doing many, many things together. We even cooked, we even did things like that. Now, yes, it wasn't accredited as far as college credits. It was a diploma, but I went on and got that and finished and took my boards, went to work in a medical field at Grant Memorial Hospital in Petersburg, West Virginia, and thought, yes, this is great. Pouring medicines from my cabinets that had multiple rows of medicines, you know, bottles hanging there, and you would pour all these bottles, nothing like Pre-Dos, you know, or things like that right now. So a friend of mine said, why don't you come to the VA? So the next thing I know, I was at the VA. And I was working on a long-term care facility. Raleigh and the VA system itself, and there came along what we called upward mobility. So upward mobility was a chance for you to go on to get your RN. And with that being said, they would pay your tuition, they would pay your books, they would even pay for, you know, you got your salary, but you still had to work, okay? So I would be getting up early, getting there about 6 o'clock, going to work, getting off at 2, rushing up the road, going to class, going to clinicals. And by the way, I didn't tell you that back while I was in LPN, I did get married that year also, so starting a family and so forth and so on. So there were many multiple things that happened, but I achieved that goal. That was something that I wanted, and if I didn't achieve that goal, I had to pay that money back, you know. So I had a determination. I wasn't paying that money back. They were giving me a free education, so I was going forward with that. As time went on, I have to tell you, I remember one time after I got my associate's, because I went right into critical care then, cardiac was my specialty, and while I was in critical care, I was getting an evaluation probably about maybe 4 or 5 years after I'd been there, and my nurse manager looked at me and said, where do you see yourself, or what do you, what is going to be your goal a year from now, 5 years from now? I looked her straight in the eye and I said, to have your job. I did. I want to say that through determination, and I'll tell you about that in a minute, but through determination, I did become her boss at one time during my career. As I went on, I got my BSN, I won't go into all of that. From there, I started many programs. Telehealth was one of the new programs that was starting for the VA center at that time. And I was one of the pioneers of starting that, along with running CBOX. And then also in the meantime, I decided I need more education. So I went back to school, got my master's. And was still working full time as I was getting that thesis and the whole works, but I was determined. And then an opening came for an associate chief nurse for ambulatory care. With that job, you would be over all the CBOX, which were 7 CBOX. Working in the emergency room also, and those that were in there, also working with inpatient, or what would be outpatient med surge, and with telephone triage. So there was quite a bit that I was over at that time, and continued that job until I decided that, you know, I've done this long enough, I want to advance some more, go further. So I took a detail, and my detail took me to Charleston, South Carolina, where I was the associate chief nurse for, at that time, it was overall nursing at that time. We were revamping nursing. Nursing was under different categories at that time, and we did pull that off and were able to continue to work that until I did become the nurse executive at that facility also. So I ended my career with being a nurse executive at the Charleston, South Carolina VA Medical Center. And so why did I brief you on that as far as my career? There were many, many other things that I actually could go into during that time, but I wanted to let you know that it is wide open. There's nothing that can stop any of you from getting and going and being into the avenue that you want to be in. It's an endless career. It opens doors and it opens challenges to you. Achieving them for yourself will be your challenge. Your commitment and desire to achieve that which you thought was impossible can be possible. Focus on forward thinking and see yourself as a nurse within the organization that strives for excellence. As the next generation of nurses graduates, which is you, It has been an honor to assist you on your journey. I'm grateful to have been part of that and have made a difference in your life. I also want to acknowledge my colleagues, Ms. Sturgill and Ms. Oxer. They played a major part in shaping you as a nurse for tomorrow. Ms. Sturgill for her cahoot, and did you get that? You know, reassuring that you understood, and Ms. Oxer, which has taken a different journey, has been dependable, supportive, and an encouraging leader. Thank you for your support and all the goodwills that you have shown the graduating nurses and me. I wish you the best. And of course, I'll be remiss if I didn't acknowledge Mrs. Perry, that has guided you from day one to the present. Without her guidance, you may still be on day one. Okay? Also remember that you do make a difference in someone's life. From small tasks to life-changing events, you are the light in their darkest moments, hope for a better tomorrow, and peace and comfort in the midst of the storm. This entitlement gives you the keys that create and to be the change that will impact that patient and or family's healing. Take this privilege to heart and never misuse what you have been given the authority to carry out. I am here to cheer you on your way to explore, achieve, and do great things in the future. As I've always said, if you didn't document it, you didn't do it. And now you have documented. You did it. Congratulations, next generation of nurses. Go forth and conquer.
When you started 11 months ago, look at where you are now, the knowledge you have. I know there were times of tears, stress. You thought you wouldn't make it, but you did. You persevered. As much as I've looked forward to this day for each of you, I must admit I always hate endings. But endings are inevitable, like the changing of the seasons, the closing of a book after you read the final chapter, the last test you take. Today is one of those days for you. Today you say goodbye to what has become familiar and routine and move forward into the career of nursing. You say goodbye to hurts, but there's so much about what you've learned in this past year from the instructors, patients, and each other that will always be part of you. There is nothing more worthwhile than the profession of being a nurse. You get to impact the lives of so many. You get to touch lives, you get to save lives. I'm sure many of you already have thought about the job that you're gonna take, the NCLEX exam that each of you will pass on your first try. So I just wanna share a few thoughts with you about the bigger picture, okay? No matter what happens in life, no matter how bad the day seems, life will go on. There will be better days ahead. Making a living is not the same as living life. Don't ever get those confused. take time every day to care for yourself mentally, emotionally, and physically. If you don't do that, you can't provide the care that your patients need from you. When you're angry, stressed, overwhelmed, take a minute, take a breath, step back. All those feelings are normal, okay? Just take a minute, take a breath. Don't react. Don't let your emotions steer your ship. Okay? Once you take a minute to breathe, you're going to see things a whole lot clearer. Okay? I heard a wonderful quote today in training. Even when you walk into a closed loop, and that patient, I'm sorry for the audience, I know that you haven't been exposed to this, but that's okay, the speech is for them, not you, okay? That patient's dead, okay? It's okay to take a deep breath, 1 or 2 seconds, okay? Everybody remembers how many seconds, minutes you have. Take a deep breath, assess the situation, don't panic, okay? Understand, you don't have to like everyone, and everyone doesn't have to like you. But you have to treat everyone with kindness and respect, the same way you want to be treated. Never be afraid of mistakes or failures. It's what you do in those moments that define you as the nurse. Learn from it. We can all agree Ms. Sturgis made mistakes, right? It's my first year as a teacher. But it's what you do. It's how you learn from it. Don't be afraid. We're all human, okay? But take a chance to learn from those moments. And you're probably not going to love the first job you take. That's the beauty of nursing. There's so much. There's a world out there for you to do. Try different things until you find what you know you love. Because when you love what you do, it's not a job anymore. When you fall down, get back up. If you get knocked down 13 times, get up 14 times. Keep on getting up. Look where you came. I keep thinking about the LPNs who went to RN school. They always say LPN school was the hardest. I'm a teacher of LPN school, and I think all RN school was the hardest. It's your first year of nursing school that's the hardest, because being a nurse is not easy. You have somebody's life in your hands. You touch that life. They may not remember your name. They may not remember your face, but they're going to remember the care they gave them. And that's what matters. Never be afraid to ask for help. It's okay to say, hey, I don't know. That was my favorite thing to tell you guys. There's no stupid question except for the one that's not asked. Know where to find your resources. And always remember, learning never ends. Ever. The only thing that stands between you and your dreams is you. Go forth and do great things. And of course, I want to thank my co-workers, Mr. Bill Bowser, always the calm in the storm, the one that held us all together, Ms. Oscar. I don't know what I would have done without you, Ms. Perry. Again, it was my first year. It was learning from me as much as them. And I thank you guys for all your patience, and you're going to do great. You're going to pass that input. Believe in yourself as much as we believe in you.
students from their campus. First, from the Raleigh County Campus, the Clinical Student of the Year is Christy Clark. The Beaver for our county campus Clinical Student of the Year is Madison Mullins. Hard work does pay off. Now I'd like to welcome Dean Wendy Patrick to the podium to say a few words for our president, Dr. Bonnie Hesenhaber. Raleigh, West Virginia. Graham from Ron Stewart.
Gabriel Hope from Hillsboro, West Virginia. Marissa Martin from Ronsford, West Virginia. Rodriguez. Odell from Somerville. Morgan Smithers from Oak Hill. Christy Carr from Beckley. Childers. Eliza Donnelly from Beckley. Shawanda Hale. Jeanette Jeanette Hicks from Mount Hope. Madeira from Fairfax. Michaela Milam from Sofia. Congratulations, everybody. Okay, so now we're going to recite the Nightingale Pledge. And you guys have, it's on the back of your program, it's on your chair. And if there are any nurses in the audience that would like to stand and recite this with us, please join us. I solemnly pledge myself before God and in the presence of this assembly to pass my life in purity and to practice my profession faithfully. I will abstain from whatever is deleterious and mischievous and will not take or knowingly administer any harmful drugs. I will do all in my power to maintain and elevate the standard of my profession and will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping and all family matters coming to my knowledge in the practice of my calling. With loyalty will I endeavor to aid the physician in his work and devote myself to the welfare of those committed to my care. This pledge was written over 100 years ago, but I still think it's pretty relevant today. So, congratulations, students, on your achievements. We wish you the very best as you continue to learn. Always remember why you became a nurse, because it will sustain you throughout your nursing journey. This concludes our pinning ceremony. Thank everyone so much for coming. Congratulations. We're proud of you. We will always be here if you need anything, okay?